automatic milking was actually Dad's idea, and he's an old school farmer, so I didn't even think he knew what it was. I didn't know what it was.
Yeah.
And he heard about it and wanted to try it, and then we learnt about it and left our jobs and came and worked on the farm.
Last year when we were transitioning, because we trained our cows halfway through the system, so they were going through their herringbone and then into the robot, we wrote off the year really before we went into it, thinking that it's a big change, we can't expect that much of our cows. But even so, training went a lot smoother than we thought. It got up and running quite quickly, and once we moved into the robot, things improved a lot for the rest of the season. So that was a pleasant surprise. And then this year, compared to last year, we're doing a whole lot better production wise.
You get told all about how to train them, but when you're actually doing it, it's quite daunting. And I found that the support we got from Lely with training, I mean, we literally couldn't have done it. You're sort of in a haze, but you know, it's good to have technicians and trainers there that know what they're doing. And so if you don't know what you're doing, at least you have someone that can be like, it's time to do this now.
Like, I think a lot of people think that because they're going through an automated system that you're not in contact with them as much. But the truth is, without the distraction of having to stand there and cut cows, you notice a whole lot more. Like, when I go into the shed to look at my cows, that's all I'm doing. I'm focused completely on them. And so even if a lot of the time the robot will pick it up, a few of the times I will in the shed. And then, you know, so sometimes it's just because I'm around them more, or because they're more comfortable. They're so relaxed that it's so easy to pick up on any kind of unusual behavior. And then other times the robot picks up on things that I'm really surprised it even did. I had one cow who always comes in. She comes in maybe every 6 hours, and she always does. And the robot alerted me because she hadn't come in for 11 hours. And then I realized she got stuck somewhere. So things like that are brilliant.
The system of detecting mastitis or lameness or anything like that is so much quicker that you get on top of it so much faster. So we really had, like, you get like one or two clinical cases of mastitis, not nearly, because I mean, in an old system you don't know really about it until you see the docket and you see a spike, and then you don't know who it
then
is.
Then you're looking around.
And so you've got to strip everyone out and find out who it is, whereas on here it'll tell you who it thinks it is before you even would see it.
Yeah, well, we're doing astronomically better than we were when we were milking in the pit. I mean, it gives us, as new people to the industry, a way of seeing what changes we make and just seeing an immediate impact. So, okay, we changed this a little bit. Did it work? Did it not? Because obviously the cows, everything is tested every day, and there's plenty of data for us to reflect on.
Automatic is a bit more accurate because it's not, like you say, it's not just a robot. Yeah. It's not the physical cups go on the cow. You've got to include things like the grazeways, which it sorts the cows for you. So, you know, they go to a certain place wherever you want them to go, and then you've got the computer system, which is a part of it as well. You know, you get to divert cows and, you know, supervise cows and all that sort of thing. Yeah. So it's a lot more than just a robotic arm.
Yeah, the automation, I suppose, starts at the paddock. It's not just when they get into the shed, because obviously I'm not going down there and pushing anyone out. It's up to them to decide when they're ready for milking. And you're manipulating it from a distance. So that's where your pasture management comes in, and that to sort of help the cows flow properly through the shed. But it's not just about when they're in the immediate shed. Obviously the robots help make that part of the process automatic, but the whole farm runs in a different way now, with cows just flowing all over the place all the time. And that allows us to have more than two milkings a day, and we don't have to stick to a set schedule. So
the challenges in dairy farming are pretty much outlined by environmental improvements and comfort to the operator and better conditions for the animals. Our cows in this system are very happy, and we enjoy that.
People like to like to know that the product that they consume is coming from a good place. And yeah, obviously people don't, you don't see the ins and outs, the day to day of a dairy farm. And but so, I think the robotic or the automated system definitely, when people can come and see the cows and see how calm they are, it definitely shifts the whole perception of dairy, the dairy industry and dairy farming.
Yeah, and I think adding the grazing element to an automated system helps that, because you can see they get to, you know, they're wandering
freely
out to the paddock and they're just hanging out all over the farm. So yeah, it's a nice scene, and it makes us happy to be farmers.
A part of it.
Yeah, because we wouldn't farm any other way, because we want to do something that we are ethically comfortable doing.
For the future of dairy farming, it's without doubt that the engineering process will improve, refine, get better and better, and I can't see anything else but a refined robotic system being taking over eventually.
Yeah, I would have. Yeah. I would have never gone into dairy farming. I would have never thought I'd be a dairy farmer if it wasn't for the robotic system. That's the reason why we came into dairy farming. I wouldn't have done it otherwise.
We wouldn't have stayed.
If someone said, "Oh, do you want to go back? And we're going to get rid of the robots and we're going to go back to the pit." My dad always likes to threaten me with that, and I'm like,
"Nope."
Being older and slower to adjust, I get a bit frustrated and sometimes chuck a bit of a sneaky comment in. And the girl said, "Well, if you go back to herringbone, Dad, you'll be milking them on your own."